Hey guys, I'm here again with another StarCraft 2 beta commentary. We're going to have Aegis as the Red Terran at the 7 o'clock up against Jayquick as the Orange Zerg at the 1 o'clock. And this map is Blistering Sands, which means that Jayquick is going to scout in the right direction with his Overlord because Blistering Sands is a two-player map. I have not heard of either of these players before. I hope that this is a good game. It wasn't recommended to me by anybody, but it was decently highly rated, and these are, I believe, platinum players, so it should be at least a decent game with a good amount of skill. If we even look at the APM, that's not good. It is the early game, so I hope that this isn't telling for the rest of the game. Yeah, Jayquick has pretty decent APM, but this 12 not doing it for me. Yeah, 18 average. Let's hope that is not indicative of the rest of the game. I guess probably just gonna wall off, we'll see. Yeah, and then just gonna put that supply depot here, I think. The add-on, the tech lab or the reactor probably doesn't block this off completely. I'm not completely sure. I don't really play Terran that much, especially not on this map. Spawning pull up, going up for Jayquick, pretty standard timing. Looks like Aegis's SCV scout gonna get in, no problem. Looks like Jayquick actually sending his Overlord in the wrong direction somehow. Maybe he's looking for proxies. Although this middle part is usually the most popular place. Well, not even. I guess down here. Well, that's weird. Oh dear, my frame rate's dropping again. Oh, there we go. I don't know. It's fluctuating. I'll just pause and then restart Fraps whenever that happens. So there might be a few breaks in the recording. So I'll try and mention that if it happens a few times. It's actually not going to blow off with his barracks. Just wanted that down. But now you're just going to wall off with supply depots. This is extremely vulnerable to any kind of bust. Hydras would break this down, no problem. Roaches might have a little difficulty with this if there are Marines up top, Marines and Marauders up top. But Banelings would completely annihilate this. Even Zerglings would probably do decent against this. The supply depot is really 350 health compared to 1,000. Just not really comparable. Aegis is going Marine Heavy for now, actually getting two gases up pretty quickly. Looks like Jayquick's expansion is almost up. Yeah, just pumping a few wings for now. Not going to commit to too much right now. There we go, that expansion is just about up. Doesn't actually have that second queen. Does he have any queens? Okay, he has one queen. Yeah, it's making its way down there. Let's go back to production. Also getting link speed, and yeah, there we go. That second queen coming out now. Alright, that's a little strange, going a tech lab and then a reactor. Usually it's tech lab reactor. We do have that third barracks up. Maybe he's just really worried about this being busted, which is very understandable. Just a few banelings will take these down, no problem. This is good. Building a supply depot near this back so we'll know when those rocks die. Jayquick has had that overlord over there for quite a while. Oh, it looks like Jayquick actually didn't send it to his base. Instead, he's just looking for when our red player Aegis expands. Looks like Jayquick gonna scout out the map with some of these lings. He already took this tower. I'm not gonna take this one. I'm just gonna move out. Looks like he's going to take down these rocks, or at least try to. These lings do take quite a while. Yeah, they just do 2 damage to these rocks. That's right, about 10 damage per second, because there's 5 of them. Maybe a little faster than that. I think it's 10 damage per second on fast instead of faster. But yeah, so Marines and the Marauder are going to clean this up, no problem. Concussive Shells has been upgraded. So getting a Creep Tumor up here. Going to spread the creep. He should, I think the first thing he should do is spread it between his main and natural so he can reinforce faster. Combat Shield being upgraded right now from Aegis. Has a pretty solid force coming out right now. Yeah, here we see that second tech lab. His army is actually much more powerful than Jake Wicks, who does have 16 lings and that single spine crawler. Versus, that's 11 Marines and 5 Marauders. These guys should be able to do quite a bit of damage. Ooh, and this Spine Crawler rerouting at a bad time. Looks like it's just gonna get down. Yeah, in time. So actually, yeah, that Spine Crawler is gonna help out a lot. And these are getting a pretty decent surround. Actually gonna be able to completely destroy Aegis' army. Very nice job there. Yeah, Aegis' army gets completely decimated. These lings, still quite a few left. I think he should at least move out and get some sort of contain right now. Or at least scout out and make sure that he's not expanding or anything. Aegis did get that factory up, getting the starport up now. Getting a tech lab on that factory. I assume we'll be seeing some tanks. We might see some Thors. And here we have this queen laying down a creep tumor, so Jake Wick will be able to connect his two bases. Jake Wick's had this lair for a while. Oh, he does have Banlings and Iron Nest. I should have seen that earlier. Yeah, it looks like Aegis is going for tanks. We'll see what comes out of this starport. Recently, early Ravens have been pretty popular. Here we can see Jake Wick is going for tanks. Ooh, gonna lift it off. That's a little strange. Okay, whatever. I don't know what that was for. Gonna put a tech cloud. So I'd like to think an early Raven. Banshees are certainly possible, considering he hasn't seen any anti-air. I'm not sure if he knows that this hydrogen is there. I'll just take a quick look. No, he doesn't. He doesn't know that hydrogen is there or that Bandling Dash is there. SCV ready. Let's see what he goes for. That tech lab is done. Yeah, he's going to go for an early Raven. That's a decent choice. I guess it's okay to get that energy up as fast as possible, and the point defense drone is very handy, but yeah, it does work on, I think it works on Hydras. I'm pretty sure it works on Hydras. And really, your starport's probably not going to be doing too much else. I suppose that first Raven, or that first Viking coming out is also good. And even a medevac, when you're going M&M&M, you need that last M, that medevac support, for it to be really good. But that Raven is completely justified for that, to get up that energy so it can lay down a point defense drone early on. Looks like J-Quick gonna take down these rocks with the gold. Probably going to expand that pretty quickly. Aegis has some more tanks on the way. Looks like he's even throwing down a few missile turrets. Yeah, getting down 3 or 4. And also, Aegis finally taking his natural expansion. This siege tank actually in a little awkward position, moving all the units back for a single overseer. No, he should have this siege tank up on the ledge over here to make sure that it covers this area. Or, I guess if he's moving out. Oh, that was a sensor tower, not a turret. Yeah, turrets are going down though. So, if he's moving out with a single siege tank, that's, I don't know, this, it's a little vulnerable to this, these Hydras that are going to come out. Yeah, a few Hydras are out, a few Investors as well, that's nice, and quite a few Zerglings, that's going to help. Jake actually going to take this gold as well. So, decent force here, a lot of Marines, a lot of Marauders, single tank, single Raven. Actually, that second tank is coming out and even producing a third tank. Not using these barracks very well though. He could probably just pump them out. Oh, centrifugal hooks coming out. That's gonna be great. Yeah, Banlings against this ball just gonna be devastating. If they can get up. Considering those other infestors are already out, so that fungal growth just gonna be great. Ooh, these bandits are attacked. Yeah, there we go. But this bandit's fucking in a bad position. They need to take them out before they can explode. They just took out one tank. Not micro.